COVID raced through Mumbai and Delhi on Tuesday, registering a massive daily spike in cases. Delhi reported 496 cases in the 24-hour period, up almost 50% from the previous day. Mumbai reported 1,377 new cases, a rise of almost 70%, and both the cities have recorded one death each. Now, if you look at the spike in cases in Mumbai in the last 3 weeks, you will see a rise of almost 33% there between the first 2 weeks, and then a rise of 188% in the subsequent week. These are the cases spiking in Mumbai in the last 3 weeks. Meanwhile, in Delhi, there is now a yellow alert and a night curfew. Schools, colleges and cinemas are closed, and there is a cap of 20 people for weddings and funerals. Meher Pandey has this report.
Crowds with many unmasked and little social distancing, even as the Delhi government announced tighter curbs. COVID cases in Delhi have increased by 166% in just 2 weeks.
थोड़ा सा दुख होता है जब देखते हैं मार्केट के अंदर इतनी भीड़ है, मॉल के अंदर इतनी भीड़ है, तस्वीरें आती हैं, वीडियो आते हैं, और इतनी भीड़ में किसी ने मास्क नहीं पहन रखा। अगर आप अपना ख्याल नहीं रखेंगे तो फिर कौन रखेगा? ये तस्वीरें नहीं आनी चाहिए बिल्कुल भी कि मार्केट के अंदर इतने भारी भीड़ लग रही है, फिर हमें मार्केट बंद करने पड़ेंगे, वो तो अच्छी चीज नहीं है। दो साल के अंदर इतनी बार पाबंदियां लगी कि आप सब लोग थक चुके हैं, लेकिन क्या करें, जरूरी है।
The yellow alert in Delhi now means that all educational institutions will be shut. Cinemas, gyms and spas will be shut as well. Restaurants and bars will shut at 10 p.m. Curfew will now start at 10 p.m. and end at 5 a.m. Public transport will operate at 50% occupancy. Weddings and funerals will be capped at 20 people. Non-essential shops in markets and malls will open with odd-even formula. Weekly markets will open at 50% capacity. Gym owners are lamenting yet another shutdown.
In the last 2 years, we have already suffered a lot. We were already under the burden of debt. Now with this lockdown, definitely this industry is going to die.
On the day that Delhi has gone into yellow alert in light of the highly transmissible Omicron variant and rapidly increasing cases, this is what the famous Sarojini Nagar market looks like. It is still crowded and some people are still unmasked. But things may look different very soon. The national capital is bracing itself for the third wave. Omicron may be playing a significant role in this. A genome sequencing lab at Delhi's Institute of Liver and Biliary Sciences, part of the InsaCog network, say that they sequence around 100 samples a day and have detected a very sharp spike in Omicron cases.
In our own experience, we have seen the Omicron cases to rise from 2 to 3% to around 30%. Of all the positive cases, and it is bound to increase in coming days. It is tipped to become the most predominant lineage in India in coming days because of the simple fact of its manifold transmissibility.
In light of the rapid increase, the Union Health Secretary also met with chief secretaries of states today to review preparedness for an Omicron-driven third wave. With Mohammad Mursaleen, Meher Pandey for NDTV.
India now has three new weapons in the fight against COVID, with the government announcing that it has given emergency use authorization to two new vaccines and one anti-COVID drug. Vishnu Shom has the details.
The vaccines which have been cleared include Covovax, known as Novavax internationally. It's being manufactured by the Serum Institute of India here in India. It's presently being exported, in fact, to the Philippines and Indonesia, so they've got a stockpile of it already. The second vaccine is largely indigenous. It's called Corbevax. It's a protein subunit vaccine. It's made by the Hyderabad-based firm Biological E. Finally, there is Molnupiravir. That's an antiviral drug made by the pharma major Merck. It'll now be manufactured in India by 13 companies for the treatment of adult patients who have a high risk of progression of the disease. Now, a decision on the rollout of the vaccines, Corbevax and Covovax, as a third booster will be taken in days. Now, that's really breaking news. So if you have received, for example, two doses of Covaxin, you could get a single third dose of one of the new vaccines, which have been granted emergency use authorization today. This would therefore follow the global practice of mix and match. However, the booster policy not yet out, so maybe we shouldn't get too ahead of ourselves, but this is being considered. In fact, both vaccines are also being considered for pediatric rollout. In other words, a rollout for children, because they've been tested on children in trials as well. So how effective are these vaccines? What do we know so far? According to Novavax, the designer of Covovax, it's about 80 to 90% effective against Delta. Remember, Omicron didn't come out when the tests happened. And also against previous variants, 80 to 90%. Corbevax is believed to be 80% effective against Delta. Remember, these are claims by the manufacturers. Significantly, both can be stored in 2 to 8 degree temperatures. Now, that's of huge consequence for us here in India where it's warmer. Finally, the new antiviral drug Molnupiravir. Now, it's being manufactured here in India by 13 companies. Its efficacy, though, underwhelms. Per the latest reports, it's at 30%. Now, in terms of doses, the way it actually works is 4 in the morning, 4 at night over a 5-day course. The expected cost, ultimately, less than 400 rupees for that full course.
In some of the news, junior doctors protesting the delay in college allotments of postgraduate medical students in Delhi have said that they will continue their agitation as talks with Union Health Minister remained inconclusive. Sonakshi Chakravarti reports.
This is the emergency ward of the Safdarjung Hospital in the national capital, but an emergency-like situation has fallen upon the doctors themselves. The resident doctors across Delhi from different Delhi medical colleges have been protesting, demanding NEET PG counseling dates. In addition to that, they have also demanded and pushed for an apology from the Delhi police, because they say that they were manhandled. Some of their doctors who are protesting peacefully, according to them, have been manhandled during these ongoing protests. So two demands were made by these resident doctors. And today, the representatives of several resident doctors' associations, including FORDA, which is the Federation of Resident Doctors, met with the health minister himself. They claim that this invitation to meet them had come from the health minister himself. So they met him, and the minister has assured them, and I quote him, they have assured them that they will consider their demands, but it is ahead of the Supreme Court on a hearing on the January 6th in the coming new year. So while this does come as a sigh of relief for many doctors protesting here, thousands of them, OPD services and in fact patients, outdoor patients coming in for treatment, the services have been impacted for the last few days. But while the resident doctors here say they are in full sympathy with their patients, but they also say that protesting and coming on the road, protesting for such long hours, even in this cold weather and despite the rain today, they say that this has been their last resort. The update so far is that the meeting with the health minister has finally taken place. So that dialogue has taken place. But at the same time, the decision to continue or not continue the strike, there was also a meeting held separately for that between the resident doctors themselves. Now, in that meeting, the resident doctors have decided that they will continue with their strike until such time further decisions are made on this. With Gauri Prasad in Delhi, Sonakshi Chakravarti for NDTV.
So once we joined our duties, once we were selected and we joined our duty, we were called the COVID batch. COVID batch क्यों बोला गया था? क्योंकि हम लोग ने COVID के time join किया था. उस दौरान हमारे ऊपर दो batches और थे. हमसे एक जो senior most batch और उससे एक senior most batch जो exam going होता है. Basically हमारा 3 साल का course है. हर साल एक नया batch आता है. तो हमारे 3 batches होते हैं. तो if you take it in a marking of 10, तो 33, 33, 33. होता क्या गया कि हमारे बैच के बाद कोई एग्जाम ही नहीं हुआ. हमारा सीनियर बैच पास आउट हो, सबसे सीनियर मोस्ट बैच पास आउट हो गया. हमसे सीनियर मोस्ट बैच अब पास आउट होने वाला है. तो हम हैं जो अकेले बचे हैं यहाँ पे एग्जाम देने वाले. तो अगर आप 10 लोगों का काम सिर्फ 3 लोगों से कराएंगे तो इफेक्ट काम करने वाले पर भी होगा और जिसकी हम सेवा कर रहे हैं उन पर भी होगा. गवर्नमेंट ये कह रही है कि हमने एक नया रिजर्वेशन सिस्टम, आपने रेट्रोस्पेक्टिवली जाके एक नया रिजर्वेशन सिस्टम जारी कर दिया है. कम से कम उन लोगों को आने दें जो आना चाह रहे हैं, जिनका एग्जाम हो गया है. हमें अभी भी 3 बैच नहीं मिलेंगे, 2 ही बैच मिलेंगे, लेकिन एटलीस्ट हमारे मरीज तो बच जाएंगे.
विद दिस थर्ड वेव वी आर स्टिल आउट हियर इन द कोल्ड. एवरी डे The doctors have been out on the roads, on the streets protesting, you know, screaming out to the government to take some action, and we are just slugging it out on every aspect. You know, we just have to slog it off. There is no relief for us in any aspect.
I feel that we are under-recognized, and the way the society perceives us is very different. And I think the media also should put us in a more positive light.